to discuss the practical that we conducted haven't conducted yet, and you should have gone on to online and had a look at the video about the practical method. So today, before we conduct the practical, we're going to briefly discuss the task sheet and then discuss the variables, the hypothesis, and then you can answer any questions you've got about the method based on your viewing of the previous video. So here we go. The purpose of this investigation is for you to look at how surface area to volume ratio affects the efficiency of diffusion. And it is a completion practical. That means the method and the materials and how to do it has been given to you. This year we'll do two of these completion practicals and we'll do one design practical. So you come up with a method. You'll come up with the variables. You'll come up with your own investigation. This is a practice for a summative one, or one that counts for grades. We're going to treat it as if it was for grades because we're going to practice the whole hand submission loop through turning in feedback through DAMAP and getting a grade. Okay? So we will be marking this, giving you a grade. In terms of how you write up a practical, the explanation for how you do that is provided in the fact sheet. So if you're looking at the hard copy, have a look at that now. I've also got it on the screen here. So if you've got your electronic copy, it's on the third and fourth page under the assessment rubric. Sorry, fourth and fifth. There are the details about how to go about writing up the practical investigation. There's lots of terminology in there that will be familiar to you to a certain degree. If you have questions about those concepts, you need to ask. You should also consult the PowerPoint that I've already distributed to you. We've already spent a lesson last week going through. When you write it up, you should use these things as your subheadings. So abstract, introduction, materials, methods, etc., the safety assessment, etc., should be your subheadings. Before you do a practical, you actually need to do some of these parts. You could do your introduction, your materials and method, and your safety assessment before you conduct the practical. In fact, you probably should do those before you do a practical, shouldn't you? So that you know what you're investigating, you identify your variables, you write your hypothesis, all of that happens within the introduction. You then outline your materials and method, and then you do your safety assessment so you can do your practical safely. So we're going to briefly touch on those things now so that we can set the scene for the practical. In this practical, what are we going to manipulate? From your thinking about what we've so far, how we've introduced it, and watching the video about the method, what are we going to investigate? What are we going to do? Excellent. We're going to test the effect. The aim is to test the effect of surface area to volume ratio on the efficiency of diffusion. That's our aim. What we need to do now is identify variables. What are the three types of variables we're going to identify? What do you think? Anybody? Anybody? Okay. Independent, dependent, control. What is your independent variable in this one? The one that you're going to manipulate. Harry?
The size of the agar cube,
and in turn, which determines the surface area to volume ratio. You are going to measure what? Or what are we going to, what is surface area to volume ratio or cube size going to affect? Let's be careful about the terminology here. The efficiency of diffusion. The efficiency of diffusion. So what are we actually going to measure in order to work out the efficiency of diffusion?
Time
is going to have to be kept constant. In order to measure the efficiency of something, the time is going to have to be kept constant. There's a control variable. What is going to be our dependent variable though? What are we actually going to measure? How are we going to determine efficiency of diffusion? Something that is going to change. The percentage change in colour. When you look at your practical sheet and you have a look at the method, you should see there that in the end you're going to calculate a percentage of cube clear. We're going to use that percentage cube to clear. We'll do some calculations to work out a percentage of cube clear. We're going to use that to determine the efficiency of the fusion. How do you think we can link the percentage cube volume of the cube clear and the efficiency of diffusion? What connections can we make between those two things? I reckon you know, Nick. High percentage cube clear. What are you going to say about the efficiency of diffusion? It was efficient. It was highly efficient. It was more efficient than a lower percentage cube clear. These are the things that should be discussed in your introduction. The identification of the variables, how they're going to be measured, how the control variable is going to be controlled, and then linking that to a hypothesis should all be summarised within your introduction. You should also, in your introduction, say what you expect to happen. What are you expecting here? You've seen the method, you've thought about the prac. What are you expecting to happen? What do you think, Abby?
The smallest cube is going to be the most efficient.
The smallest cube is probably going to show the highest efficiency in terms of diffusion. Absolutely. That's not a big mystery in this practical. What this practical is designed to do is to help you with the method, the way of writing up the practical, the manipulation of the apparatus, the thinking that goes behind it, the drawing of the graph. That's what this is actually all about. Questions at this point? Adam. Good question. If it is expected that, or is a way to write it, that's not necessarily past tense. You don't have to. The independent variable is. It is expected that. I think writing it in those terms is the preferred method. Seen the video. What are your questions about the method? Ready to go. Have you thought about sample size? In a moment, when I put some safety gear on and do it properly. In a moment when I give you a slab data, what are you going to start doing with it? Hacking it up and making a little snowman, having fun with it? No. Maybe later, but for a start. What are you going to do? Get the cube, what are you going to do? Start measuring it. How many cubes are you going to cut up? Three, 11, 12, 14,
yeah.
One.
Nine,
okay. Why did you choose the number having nine? Three is the smallest valid sample size. There are three different independent variables in this practical. A 3x3 cube, a 2x2 cube, and a 1x1 cube. In the method, it also talks about a length of time. 5 minutes will be ample for this to happen. Okay? As long as you keep all of your replicates, all of your samples are kept at the same length of time, you'll be fine. So yes, you're going to come and grab your agar block. Yes, you're going to cut up cubes. Safety involved in that is obvious because you're going to use a little knife. What else are you going to do in this practice?
Measure out the
sulfuric acid. Safety around using sulfuric acid. What are your thoughts there? Will you drink it?
No.
you don't consume anything in a science lab, including sulfuric acid. And don't, please don't eat the agar either. Be safe, use safety glasses, use gloves, and wear an apron. Anything else you want to ask about the practice? Yeah,
culture.
So get that out in a moment. Abby?
Should the sulfuric acid be exactly the same measurements for each of the 4 units?
You should try and keep the volumes even, because that may have an effect on diffusion. May. But you wouldn't, I would, what's more important in that is, in terms of the amount of sulfuric acid, is that all surfaces are covered. Other questions? Claire?
In the video, like this, the 1x1 or 2x2 in one beaker, should we do that, or in 3?
Yeah, yep. So, the question there is, in the video, they were in, the two little ones were in the same beaker, and the bigger one was in the larger beaker. Fine, that method's fine. If you want to do something else, that's okay too. If you want to have them all in the same feature and then try and do 3 replicas at the same time, that's okay too. That would be tricky though, because of time, getting them all out at the same time and doing your measurements at the same time. If you want to have them all in the same beaker, what would you need to think about there? You don't have to answer that. Anyone else can answer if you want. You have them all in the same beaker, what are the sort of things you need to think about?
That they're not touching?
Yeah, at all available surfaces. Is exposed to the diffusion of the area. Other questions? Good question. Other questions?
Should we take photos?
Yeah, absolutely. You should take photos. You could take a little video to remind yourself. Whatever helps you learn. Can you include photos in your prep write-up? Yeah. No.
Is it recommended that we have photos in our prep?
Not necessarily recommended. Diagrams if you want,
yep.
Not required. Other questions? Excellent. I will now stop the video and invite you off.